press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi students, we are discussing about the magnetic force on a moving charge in a magnetic field. So the two important relations, the force experienced by a charge moving in a magnetic field, F equal to Q into V cross B, and Lorentz force, the force experienced by a charge moving in a combined electric and magnetic field. And when it enters perpendicular, you come to know it describe a circle, the charge, and have radius mv upon bq, the period and velocity that requires. All these we have discussed in the previous session. However, we have to see some numericals on this as per J and NEET concern. Let us take the first question as find the instantaneous direction of the force in the following case. So we are given the charge Q moving in this direction. Magnetic field is given, cross magnetic field perpendicular to the board. And the direction usually assumed is X, Y and Z. This is direction I. This represents I. This unit vectors K. And told you that if it is clockwise, a negative value comes. If the product is taken anti-clockwise, it will be positive. Keeping in mind, we can easily find the direction of the force. The force on this in what direction is quotient. So we can use for that easily the equation F is equal to Q into V cross B. So now it clearly indicates V is along Y direction, means I can write VJ. And B is into the board, implies it is BK but negative because minus side. J direction we have taken outside here, but it is into the board minus K. So substituting here Q into VJ cross B into minus K. This I can write it as QVB minus I brought J cross K. Now you see the J cross K. J cross K is anti-clockwise. I comes positive. So that means minus QVB into I. I refers the direction, but it is minus. Or I can write QVB minus I is the direction of the force. Force magnitude is QVB and along negative X axis. Along negative X axis, the force experiencing with this magnitude QVB. So that how we can directly using the cross product and vector algebra knowledge, very easy to find the direction of the force experiencing by the charge moving in the magnetic field. Another question, come to the second one. A magnetic field B equal to 4 into 10 power 3 is acting in the Z direction of Tesla, exerts a force F equal to 4i plus 3j into 10 power minus 10 Newton on a charge particle having charge of 10 power minus 9 coulomb moving in xy plane. Find velocity of the particle. See, when you look into this question, velocity components can exist. First remember here, it is in the xy plane. Vxi plus Vyj, I have to think. The first thinking, because charge is in the xy plane and B is in the z plane. And I told you that always when the charge enters perpendicular to the magnetic field, describe a circle perpendicular to the plane containing the magnetic field. Therefore, the charge describe a circle when B is into the board here. Corresponding to that, it is describing a circle of definite radius as it moving toward. The velocity components are x and y. So we have to find V. They given the charge and magnetic field and the force acting on it. Therefore, the solution when come to, we have to take the equation Q into V cross V. Force already given, 4i plus 3j into 10 power minus 10 equal to 10 power minus 9. In place of V, I can write this. I told you it is in the xy plane. Therefore, its components are x and y. Vxi plus Vyj cross B equal to 4 into 10 power 3k. Minus 3 or plus 3? Minus 3. It is minus 3k. So minus 3, minus 12, minus 10. So it become 4i plus 3j into 10 power 2 equal to minus 3. I removed that 4 into Vxi plus Vyj cross k. 4 I written here. So if I taken into the bracket, it become 400i plus 300j equal to I cross k 4 into I cross k. You see that I cross k, I am moving in the clockwise direction. I cross k means it must be j, but it is minus. Minus j into I cross k is Vx. Plus j cross k. You see, j cross k is anti-clockwise. I is positive. That means Vy into 4i. This we get. So if I write again, 400i plus 300j equal to 4vyi minus 4vxj. Now we can compare the both sides, I components with I component. So therefore, V4Vy is equal to 400, which implies Vy is equal to 100 meter per second. Similarly, this J component minus 4Vx is equal to 300. Or Vx is equal to minus 300 by 4 is minus 75 meter per second. Therefore, velocity value is, already we written Vxi plus Vyj. Therefore, it is minus 75i plus 100j meter per second. This is the answer. We got V value is equal to minus 75i plus 100j meter per second finally. So I hope you are followed. As B is acting perpendicular to, this represents perpendicular to the magnetic field. Then xy plane, the circle describing, and also velocity is in the xy plane. X component and Y component has to be determined. For this, we use the equation. F is given, charge value given, Vi split into X and Y component and B given. Simplifying using vector algebra, we got this. Comparing the I and J components, we got Vy equal to 100 and Vx is equal to minus 75. That we substituted and final answer written. I hope you are understood it clearly. Let us go to the next one. See, the given the next is about if a particle of charge 1 microcoulomb is projected into a magnetic field B equal to 2i plus yj minus zk with a velocity equal to 4i plus 2j minus 6k, then it passes undeviated. So the charge passes undeviated. Then it passes undeviated. If it is, it is the first part. In the second part, if it is now projected with a velocity I plus j, then find the force experienced by this charge. There are two parts in this problem. In the first part, they are saying that a charge of magnitude 1 microcoulomb is made to move with this speed or velocity in the magnetic field. What observed is passes undeviated means, that means B and V are parallel. B and V are parallel, then it is undeviated means proceed straight. It is traveling along a straight line. B and V theta is zero. So if that is the case, but actually if this same charge is moving in the same field with this velocity, what the force it experience? So in the second part itself, if I write, so that we required the force is Q into V1 cross B. I have Q value 1 microcoulomb is minus 6. V1 is I plus J I have. Cross, when I write B, I want the component of Y and Z. JK, component of J, 2I I have. Plus Y and Z is not known. Unless that is finding, we cannot get a solution to this. The problem locks here. Because I get this given, YJ is not given. To find YJ, they given this hint. When they are parallel, then no doubt I can take the ratio that this part, in the first part I can, as parallel, V and B are, I can write Vx by Bx, Vy by By equal to Vz by Bz, which implies 4 by 2 is equal to 2 by Y is equal to minus 6 by minus Z. If you compare the first two, so Y is equal to 1. And also if you compare these two, so cancelling to Z, 6 by 2 is Z equal to 3. Comparing these two, we got Y is equal to 1 and Z equal to 3. Substitute in this, B, 2I plus I minus 3 plus J minus 3K. Thereby, the B value become now 2i plus 1j minus 3k. This I substituted here. If you simplify this, we get the answer. For that, you can use this F equal to, I can only use the ijk, for I 110, for this 2 1 minus 3. Let the force, what happens, 10 power minus 6 into I into I column you leave, this minus 3, other is 0, minus J into J column, it is again minus 3, other is 0, plus K into K into 1 into 1, 1 minus 2. So F is equal to 10 power minus 6 into minus 3i plus 3j minus k. This is the answer. What is the force? In suppose you want magnitude, magnitude of force, 10 power minus 6 into root of 3 square plus 3 square plus 1 square, which gives you root 19 into 10 power minus 6 newton. This is in terms of newton. They given B and V. Vasa's undeviated hint given is B and V are parallel, by which we can determine Y and Z. But that is not the field to which the charge is subjected. To find the force, they given the velocity, this, and magnetic field is given. We determined value from the given condition, and a cross product of these two given the result here. Coming to the next one. A proton and a alpha particle. Proton and a alpha particle. That means doubly ionized helium nucleus are accelerated through a same potential difference. Potential difference same. Under the same PD, they are accelerated. And enter a region of uniform magnetic field, B same, with their velocities perpendicular to B, theta is 90. Compare the radius of their paths followed by them. Suppose if we have a magnetic field which is acting into the board, and a proton, there is a potential difference to which these both are accelerated, proton and alpha particle. They gained some energy and entered the transverse magnetic field, which are acting perpendicular. Thereby, they may describe the circles. But the question is radius of the alpha particle and radius of the proton. They are accelerated to same potential difference. So for this radius of the, because as it entered perpendicular to B, it describes a circle, and radius of the circle described by them is given by mv upon bq. So mv can be written as 2 m ev qv, qv by bq, or this can further be written 2mv upon b square q. However, here this potential difference is same. V is common, b is common, which suggests in this problem, comparison is depend on the m by q. Therefore, if I want comparison of proton radius with that of alpha particle, so I can write with square root under that condition, mass of proton by mass of alpha into charge of alpha by charge of proton. If I take, because proton has mass 1, then alpha particle as a helium nucleus has 4. Charge, if you taken it as 1, it has 2. Charge of alpha particle is 2. So therefore, mass of proton is 1 by 4. and charge is 2 by 1, which is equal to 1 by root 2. So comparison, I can write Rp by R alpha is equal to 1 by root 2, or Rp is to R alpha equal to 1 is to root 2. So condition we taken from this and obtained that. Let us go to the next one. So in the another example, if a charged particle thrown with a double the speed in transverse magnetic field. Magnetic field is into the board if you imagine. Earlier velocity was V1 is V. What they are saying is V2 is made two times of V. It has a definite charge and mass same. The same charge, what we made is doubled the speed, thrown with double speed in a transverse magnetic field. How do its radius and time period of revolution is changes? You have to find out the time period of revolution and radius. Already this charge particle entering magnetic field describes the circle, have a radius whose value we come to know that R is equal to mv upon bq, and time taken to describe is a 2 pi m upon bq relation we have. When the particle enters perpendicular to the magnetic field, so when we see this first case, comparison of radius R2 by R1, V2 by V1, because R is found to be directly proportional to V, R is proportional to V directly. Therefore, R2 by R1 is a 2V by V, implies R2 is equal to 2 times of R1, first answer. But second, T is independent of V. No term of velocity here, only we changed the velocity, but it does not affect the time period. Therefore, I can write T2 is equal to T1 without affecting the period. T2 equal to T1 and R2 equal to 2R1. When a charge particle moving at certain velocity, we are increased the velocity to double. Then what happens to radius means radius of the circle doubles, but period of revolution remain same, is not affected. Let us come to the another problem. A beam of proton with velocity, a beam of proton charge moving with velocity 4 into 10 power 5 meter per second enter in a region of uniform magnetic field of 0.3 Tesla. Find the radius of the helical path. When it makes an angle equal to 60 degree with respect to B, and also the pitch of the helix. See, this is the direction of the magnetic field. If I assume charge particle, that proton is entered this, making an angle of 60 degree with respect to the magnetic field. So it describes a helical path, but therefore I found one perpendicular point is V, as if I take here opposite side by hypotenuse is sine 60. And this is V cos 60. The path become helical in this case because it is not entering perpendicular or parallel. The path is like this. In that, I have to find the pitch value also. However, this perpendicular component of velocity make it to describe a circle, and first if I come to the point, radius of the circle, radius of circle that it is describing is mv upon bq. As a proton charge value is 1.6 10 power minus 19 coulomb, mass as 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg. That mass is 1.67 into 10 power minus 27 kg, and velocity they given 4 into 10 power 5, but here it is perpendicular. V perpendicular means V sin 60. Sin 60 is root 3 by, this I have to substitute as V sin 60. V value is this, sin 60 is root 3 by 2. B value given 0.3 into Q 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. So MV upon BQ, mass, charge given, that velocity is 4 into 10 power 5, sin 60 is root 3 by 2, B value. I am approximating these to cancel, and I can write this as a root 3 and this as 2. 20 cancelling here, 20 if I take to the 20 minus 20 cancelled, minus 2 remained. So 2 by root 3 into 10 power minus 2. It is 1.7. Therefore, I can write approximately or near to 1.2 into 10 power minus 2 meter or 1.2 centimeter. The radius of the circular path, the charge describing under this field moving. The second part, pitch of the helix. Pitch of helix, that nothing but V parallel into period. This, when the proton completes one circular motion in its path, how much linearly covered along the direction of B? That is V parallel. V parallel is V cos 60 into 2 pi r V perpendicular. V perpendicular can be written nothing but as V cos 60 into 2 pi r divided by V sin 60. V cos 60, V sin 60, you are knowing 2 pi into 1.2 into 10 power minus 2 by tan 60. Tan 60 is root 3. Root 3, if I multiplied by root 3, 3, that 3 approximately root 3 remains. This I can approximate as 2 into 1.2 into pi is, if approximated, then it may be root 3 into 10 power minus 2. If you work it out, it comes to be 4.10 power minus 2 meter or 4.4 centimeter is the answer. So we get both here. Value of R is comes to be 1.2 centimeter and this pitch is 4.4 centimeter. We got answer. So I given you MV perpendicular has to substitute here. This component perpendicular to B describe the, make the charge to describe the circle. V perpendicular, V sin 60 substituted and we got the answer as 1.2. T is a 2 pi r V perpendicular, V parallel is V cos 60. Sin 60 by cos 60 is tan 60, substitution given that answer. Coming to the next example, a magnetic field applied in a cyclotron. In a cyclotron, a magnetic field is applied whose magnitude is 3.5 Tesla. What is the frequency of electric field necessary that must be applied between the D's in order to accelerate the proton. Proton has to accelerate. What must be the frequency necessary? In case of cyclotron, you got the equation for frequency of electric field. Frequency of electric field, F equal to BQ upon 2 pi m. B is already given 3.5, proton 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 divided by 2 pi into 1.67 into 10 power minus 27. So approximately, if I cancel, this is 6, 3.5 by 6.28 into minus 27 is 10 power 7. It's 8. If I made it is minus 27, 9 is 8. So if I simplified, you will get around 5.35 into 10 power 7 hertz. It is the frequency of electric field required to accelerate under this magnetic field. Maximum you can get it. Coming to the next one. Magnetic field applied on a cyclotron. Again, in a cyclotron, magnetic field applied is 0.7 Tesla. The radius that it maximum describing is 1.8 meter. What will be the energy of the emergent proton in mega electron volt? Maximum energy that is gained, how much in mega electron volt? In a cyclotron, energy gained by proton is given by B square Q square R square by 2m. B is given 0.7 whole square. Q square is 1.6 as it is proton given, charge of proton, radius 1.8 square given, divided by 2 into mass 1.67 into 10 power minus 27. This answer comes in joules. Answer comes in joules. If you want in mega electron volt to convert, again this you have to divide by that. So this, if you simplify, you will get around 76 into 10 power 6 electron volt or 76 mega electron volt. On simplification, you arrive at here direct equation and direct substitution to find the kinetic energy of the emergent charged particle. Using that equation, we can estimate directly. Now here given a situation where the magnetic fields are shown. The magnetic field in this, magnetic field is into the board, cross transverse magnetic field into the board applied. Path of the charged particles mentioned. So one path is like this, with this direction of velocity. Another is like this, velocity direction. It is for A, it is for B, and another is for C. This is for C, and another go like this as a D. These are the direction of velocities given for different cases. What is their question is, four charged particles enter the region of uniform magnetic field. Trajectories are shown. What are the signs of the charges? You have to find the signs of the charges. A sign of charge. What is the sign of charge of B, C and D? This question is on Fleming's left-hand rule. Field is into the board. You know, forefinger represents the direction of the field. Middle finger, motion of the positive charge, velocity of the positive charge. And thumb represents the direction of the force, means its path. Now, this is the direction of B. Direction of B. And entry is like this. You assume this represents the entry of the charge here into the magnetic field. This is a direction of V and direction of B is perpendicular. Thumb represents, if it is a positive charge, then it could have been traveled like this. Opposite travels, according to Fleming's left-hand rule, this is the direction of the positive charge motion. Opposite motion says it is a negatively charged. And similarly, when you take in this case, V is towards this. Again, if you look into, this is the direction of the field, this is the entry of that. So now direction of the field and entry. Direction of field is into the board, charge is coming into that. Then again, what this suggests is towards downward. So if you imagine, this is the magnetic field and charge is to be moved like this. You see, this is the direction of the charge motion. Forefinger representing into the board. See, look into. And thumb represents downward, means this is the direction of the positive charge. It is moving upward, opposite to the positive charges. It is also negatively charged. Coming to C, take here any point. So this you can easily follow that it is V, B is into the board. See now, this is B, this is V, and force is acting upward. Or in this case also force is inward. In this case force is inward. Describing a circle rightly, this is holding good for positively charged particle. Because this follows Fleming's left-hand rule for positive charge, which are applying correctly. Because forefinger into the board, charge right and force inward. Or even in this case, if you take every point, it moves in the anticlockwise direction. Magnetic field is into the board and anticlockwise the field is, charge is positive. That is positively charged. It is not deflected. Undeflected suggests it is a uncharged particle or a neutral particle. We say neutral particle or uncharged particle. So how that is, it is negatively charged, it is also negatively charged, it is positive charge, it is not charged, not have charge. That is how, using the Fleming's left-hand rule, we determine the sign convention of the charges that we possess, identified by passing them through the transverse magnetic field. Let's come to another. So another example, there is a semi-transverse magnetic field into the board. Every point the field is into the board. Charges are made to enter here. With the same momentum, P same, which is equal to MV for all. So what we are seeing in this is here, article 1 move straight, which is represented 3. Another moves like this, and another one, 4 and 5, and this is second one, and third, first one. Direction of the magnetic field is into the board. We have to say, so once again I read, a proton and alpha particle, a proton, alpha particle, and a neutron a electron and unknown particle unknown particles enter the region of uniform magnetic field enter the region of uniform magnetic field with equal momentum same momentum for all same Figure shows the path followed by the particles. Identify which path corresponds to which particle. First, here radius is describing. Circular path, the charge particles, all of them describe. The reason is, this is the velocity component if I take. The velocity component initially. B and V are perpendicular, B perpendicular to V, therefore radius is MV upon BQ, MV upon BQ we have, but they told this is same, P same, same for all, therefore I can say that R is only with the charge, because B same, B is common for all the charges, and momentum is same, then only the radius is changing with depending on the charge. And using the left hand rule, first you confirm positive and negative charges are mixed, the electron proton is there. Magnetic field into the board, charge enters the region. Field is into the board or out of the board, board is given out of that, let us be. They given like this. Field is out of the board. Charge is given. Now you think this is the direction of the field. This is the direction of the field. Forefinger towards us. This is charge enters. Positive charge is moving down. That means these charges must be positive, these charges must be negative, it is uncharged because no deflection. One confirmation I can say, third one is the path of neutron because it is a neutral particle. It is undeflected, proceeds straight under the influence of magnetic field. Both are positive means 4 and 5. Both are positive, and if you look into R is inversely with Q, if radius is large, charge is less. 4, radius of the fourth one is greater than radius of the fifth one, because it describes a smaller radius, it is having a larger radius. Larger the radius, charge of the fourth one is less than charge compared to the charge of the fifth. Out of proton and alpha particles, which is having less charge? Proton. Therefore, the path 4 goes to proton and path 5 goes to alpha particle. I think you are understood here. Why I selected path 4 is a proton and path 5 is for alpha particle. And coming to the other negative, see this proton and electron, both are same. That means R is Q. So 2 and 1 are negative charges. But radius of the second is almost equal to radius of the fourth, that of the proton means. 2 must be electron, opposite charge. Opposite charge, it is electron. And this may be unknown particle. Unknown charged particle with, however you know, charge of that is higher than QE. This is unknown. Charge of the first one is higher than that of the electron. It has the charge more than that of electron. And it is no doubt electron are compared on this basis, because radius of electron proton are same, because of the momentum same. Therefore, 2 must be electron. This is an charged particle, unknown particle, having charge more than that of electron. It is a proton and it is a alpha particle. I think you have understood that, how this happened. So applying the Fleming's left-hand rule, this represents the direction of the magnetic field, and this represents the direction of velocity or momentum. This given the positive charge, R only depends on Q, which made it proton and alpha particle. Quite opposite, only charged, it is electron, and it is uncharged, unknown charged particle. So coming to the next one. A charged particle having charge 2 coulomb is thrown with velocity 2i plus 3j inside a region having electric field 2j and magnetic field 5k. Find the Lorentz force acting on them. Find the initial Lorentz force on charge Q. Lorentz force EQ plus Q into V cross B relation we have. E given as 2J into 2 coulomb plus Q, 2 coulomb into V is 2I plus 3J cross B K, 5K, 4J plus, again I show here it is X, Y and Z. So this is I, J, K. Clockwise negative, anti-clockwise positive. So I cross K is clockwise, minus. 5, 2 is 10, 20. Minus J, 20. Plus J cross K is I plus 5, 3 is 30, I. This become 30i minus 16j, minus 20 plus 4. So the Lorentz force on the charge is 30i minus 16j. The possible answer in this we got. Let us see the next. So we are taking some special cases here. Transverse magnetic field is applied. This is the field in which the charges has to move. When enters normal to the field, it is the velocity, charge and mass of the particle. Velocity of the particle entered perpendicular. No doubt, according to Fleming's left hand rule, if I applied, it describes a semicircle and comes out of that in the other side. So this angle describing is nothing but 2 pi at the center. This is the path described by the charged particle in the magnetic field, semicircle exactly. So then the separation between them is a 2r. If r is the radius of the circle it described, then what is the radius expression is mv. Radius expression I can take here is mv upon bq. Again, as it enters perpendicular, period equal to 2 pi m upon bq. This is the path we are taking for this hole, but actually the angle formed is 180 degree pi. So I am writing with that color only. Now the answer for this is pi m by bq. Expression for period directly can be written, and the radius of the semicircle is described. If it enters perpendicular to b and v perpendicular to each other. When entered, so this describes a semicircle with radius r given by me upon bq, and period time taken to cross it. Time taken to cross, instead of period I say it is time taken to cross the magnetic field. Come out of the magnetic field, half the circle it present, pi m by bq. Similarly, let us take the same situation, but enters part of that. So this is the path described. Velocity q and m. Now with respect to the magnetic field observed, so if I extend it, it will form, it is entering, making an angle theta, and this also become theta at the center, and this may be the radius of the circle that it is describing in the magnetic field. Across the magnetic field we have entry is perpendicular to B, it wants to describe a circle but not 50%, it part when it enters making an angle with respect to this vertical line. Here also this become theta. So because this, if we extend it, now this is almost 90 degree. Opposite is 90, theta. It is 90 minus theta because this is 90. If this is theta, this is also theta. This is 90 minus theta, therefore this must be theta. Similarly, here also this become theta. So what is the angle between them is 2 theta. In this case also, radius is no variation, mv upon bq. Immediately you can write, even in this case, the radius of the arc that it is describing equal to bq. And time it taking is, so that is 2 theta, total angle forming. Here angle formed is pi, we return pi m upon bq. The time taken is 2 theta into m upon bq. Instead of pi, I total angle taken and directly return 2 theta m upon bq. We can derive it and show easily. So the formula is 2 pi m upon bq whole period. For the period of revolution, completing is 2 pi. If it completes one circle, half circle pi, it describes part of an arc, subtend in angle 2 theta, interior angle 2 theta m upon bq. I am showing another one case in this. For conveniency, I made sometimes the field may be giving like this. F field is out of the board and charge is coming. So when it enters here, Q and mass M, so this describes a circle and emerges like this. So I can draw the this is tangent, and here it is theta, and this is also theta, forming total angle is 2 pi minus 2 theta. The path covered is this. This angle is theta. It entered with angle. Very carefully observe the angle. If this is theta, then 90 minus theta, as it is 90, this should be theta. With respect to entering perpendicular to the B, no doubt it describes a circular path, but how much the arc length in terms of angle is 2 pi minus 2 theta. Again, in the case, I can write B equal to 2 pi, radius equal to mv upon bq, no doubt. But time is, instead of 2 theta, I have to write 2 pi minus 2 theta into m upon bq. Or I can write this as 2 into pi minus theta m upon bq. So these are the different cases where directly the questions may ask about the time taken to, what is the time taken to come out of the field once it entered at some angle theta, either this or the previous two cases I explained. So coming to the other, there is a transverse magnetic field again. So there is a restriction. And here is the path. This distance is D. Magnetic field is applied perpendicular at every point the field is. So the question on this is about, if this is the D, if it has to describe, if it is entering, a charge is entering here with charge Q and mass M with a velocity V. So if it has to describe the circular path, it has to move out. Then no doubt, the normal, if I draw, R and this side is R, and this may be theta. This is the path which travels as it enters. To describe the radius, semicircular path to pass out. If these two are R, D, the distance, this is the maximum length of the magnetic field in which the charge can travel. There is a restriction, again there is. So D must be greater than R. Radius, greater than the radius of the circle, the charge describes. That means here R is D must be greater than mv upon bq. What is the velocity required if you want? That must be less than dbq by m. Velocity should not exceed for the given D, for the given charge having mass m and q. The rate velocity of the charge particle should not exceed this magnitude, where D is the maximum horizontal distance it can travel. That means, in order to describe the circle, the condition is this. Is another one. Suppose in the same situation, if the particle is slightly changing this, I can show with that one. So the another example, let us imagine in the same case, there is a magnetic field transverse applied into the board. One charge is minus, other charge is plus Q and M. It is minus Q and M. The separation between them is D. They should not collide each other while they are passing through this. However, negative charge come like this. And positive charge enter and go like this. They describe a semicircle, no doubt, in this field as transverse inward magnetic field given. Direction for negative charge and positive charge. In order to, they should not collide. They should not collide. Means this should be, if it describe a radius R1 and it should describing a radius R2, D must be greater than R1 plus R2 is a condition. Or D must be greater than M into V1 plus V2 upon VQ. This condition is necessary to get that one. I hope you are followed here. They should, when field is applied perpendicular to the board, into the board, two charges at a separation D normally entered. They describe a semicircle, no doubt. While describing, they should not collide means R1 plus R2 should be greater than D. So D, that must be, sorry, greater than. D must be greater than R1 plus R2. Right. Then there is no collision. D must be greater than R is MV upon BQ. Therefore, M into V1 plus V2 upon BQ. Q and M same. Only charge is one positive, one negative. Mass same. Velocities are different. Then this is the minimum condition. They come out of the field without collision mutually. And coming to the another example, and there is a transverse field applied, and this distance is D. Distance is D. Transverse magnetic field B is applied. Charge entered with the Q and mass M with the velocity V here. This is the direction of velocity. As it experiences a magnetic field, it starts going like that. So this is the path B given. How much deflection that the charge particle took place from the direction of incident when it emerges out from the other limited transverse magnetic field applied. Under the limited transverse magnetic field, charge particle traveled and moving out of it. With respect to the horizontal, if it is making an angle theta and aiming out. So if I extend it, this become theta here. So no doubt, I am drawing here perpendicular to that. It is the radius become. And no doubt this is radius and this may be R dash up to here C, O if I called. Now this is the question, how much deflection from entry point to exit point, how much it is deviating? Deviation Y is equal to, I can write from this R minus R dash. Suppose with respect to the incident direction, it is turned through an angle theta, This is theta. This is 90 minus theta. As this is 90 degree, this will be theta only. If that is theta, R dash by R is cos theta. therefore I can write it as r minus r cos theta, or y is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta is a relation, deviation cost. Suppose you want to estimate theta, again sin theta, if you take sin theta, the second part, sin theta is, this is d, nothing but maximum transverse length field, d by r, and you know r is equal to mv upon vq. You are knowing the d value, you are knowing b value given, q value, charge and mass, you can estimate theta. Sin theta, theta can be estimated. If theta substituted here, you will get the value of deflection cost. When it enters from one point and exits at the other, what is the maximum deviation taken place from the incident path is estimated by that. This r minus r dash gives you the magnitude of deviation. R by r dash, r dash by r gives you cos theta. R into 1 minus cos theta. Sin theta is opposite side by hypotenuse. D by r, r is me upon vq. That's what we observed in that. So let us come to another question. It's about a particle of specific charge. Specific charge alpha equal to q by m, moving from origin under the action of electric field is EI and magnetic field is B naught K, its velocity at x 0, 0 is given as 4i plus 3j. Find the value of x, how much? Value in terms of some values we have to write. So the best solution in this is, as it entering the magnetic field, E and combined fields, E and B, work done, as enters it, is half mv square, is a change in kinetic energy, is F dot x. The relation can be used. F dot x relation we can use in that. Under, as it enters magnetic field work done is zero, no question of taking that. Half m, if you want velocity, I can obtain from this, v is equal to root of 4 square plus 3 square equal to 5. So m, let it be remain as it is. F is eq into I. They given eq I dot x I, that is also. This become ei, e into ei dot x I. Or it i dot i is 1 E into EX. Now this is E by M is alpha. Therefore electric field, X value, you are asked about X. If you want X here, this MV square, M into V is 5 square divided by 2 into E. But E by M is alpha. This 25 by E by M into 2. E by M into 2. This E by M, if I take to the denominator, then it become 25 into 2 alpha, because E by M is alpha. 25 by 2 into E alpha. I think you are followed. Work done by magnetic field is 0. Electric field only does the work. That F dot H, half M E square. Velocity we obtained from that, 5 into 25. M, 25. E I taken to the denominator. Here E, X, E only. E, X, X. So E cancels. Here E cancels. Q is equal to EI. Q is like that only. No? Q is EI. So, correction I do here. So, half M V square is equal to F dot X. Half M into 5 square equal to E into QI dot XI is equal to EQI dot XI equal to 25 M by 2. But Q by M, X is equal to, here EQ remained, 25 divided by 2 into Q by M into E. This E remains, I left that in the previous. E remains as it is here. That become 25 divided by 2E into alpha. Is the expression for X. So we discussed some questions in this. I made the correction that F A dot X, F is EQ, EQ, E is EI. But Q as it is, EQI, XI, then Q by M is taken as the charge. So we taken some examples in this. We have to try with specific questions in the next videos. In the next video, we start about the force experienced by a current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field. Thank you.